what we call black use of these weapons, but not in any significant way, and certainly not in such a way that one would conclude that they've had any impact.
But let's look at the Pentagon budget figures to see how important the outlay is for direct energy weapons.
So right now, you have about $50 million a year being spent on non-lethal weapons. You have about another $200 million or so being spent on high-power microwave, active denial type systems. You've got probably another $100 to $200 million being spent on secret black laser programs. And then you've got the big lasers, the high-energy laser of the Air Force and the other tactical lasers. So probably, well, when you add all of that up, you know, the United States is probably spending $500 million a year right now on directed energy weapons, you know, probably somewhere in the order of 300, 400 million euros. So this is a significant amount of money. This is the size of the defense budgets of some countries in Europe.
People might think that energy weapons only pose a danger for the countries involved in a military conflict, but that's not the case. One particular weapon called the Active Denial System, better known as the Pain Ray, has been built specifically for use in maintaining public order. Given its claim to be non-lethal and the suffering it produces, this weapon could become a very controversial one.
The active denial system is a millimeter wave system, operates about 93 gigahertz, sends out a beam for a very long distance. And what's important about it is that when it hits the skin, it penetrates only a very slight, a few millimeters into the skin. And it hits the pain receptors and causes, you know, people to be averse to the pain. It hurts. Hurts a lot.
How long can he...
The tests that have been run, they were to go to 3 seconds. Each individual was given a kill switch. Nobody made 3 seconds. The onset of pain is extremely rapid. And you don't have to do it very long. I mean, it gets your attention instantly.
To understand the consequences this new weapon could have for human rights, we went to the Empire State Building in Manhattan, home of the offices of Human Rights Watch, one of the most important human rights organizations.
We can see the effects of a gun very easily and understand them. But when you cannot see the effects of a weapon because it is not visible and because the science is not very well understood because it's so new, then it becomes of grave concern to us and raises the stakes for potential human rights violations and abuses. Pain is induced upon the people. And that's what we have to understand about the active denial system, that it exists to create pain. And that's very different than most other non-lethal weapons, where the desire is to either immobilize someone or make it so that they cannot walk in an area. And we have to be very careful because in international law, it's very clear that devices created solely for the creation of pain can eventually lead to torture and are therefore illegal. And it's very critical that the United States does a careful legal review of the active denial system and is open with their findings. To date, they have not been open.
Some people say, oh, acoustic weapons or high-power microwave weapons, the active denial system, we can use it for crowd control. Well, crowd control, what does that mean? It pretends that everyone in the crowd is 18 years old and male and in good health. And we're just going to shoot these microwaves or shoot these acoustic weapons at this crowd, and it's going to be carefully calibrated at a power level and an intensity and a range to affect all these 18-year-old men in the crowd. Well, what crowd is made up of just 18-year-old men? Look at the Intifada. Look at any riot in Iraq today. Children, women, pregnant women, old people.
There's been a lot of discussion also about the potential for eye damage, that in fact They have done some tests on the skin to show that it's not harmful, but where is the eye test? And that there have been concerns raised by scientists about potential harm to the eyes. And we also have concerns about the effects to children, to the infirm, to the elderly. Why are they not producing the data? Why are they not sharing it with us?
As for the use of the pain ray in the field of war, the Defense Industry Daily website reports that 3 sheriff vehicles were ordered at the price of about $31 million, and that approval has been requested for another 14 vehicles by Brigadier General James Hagen, Chief of Staff of the Multinational Forces in Iraq.
In my view, the next global conflict has already begun, and we don't have an understanding of what that conflict looks like. But because of the issues of terrorism, for instance, the adversaries are going to be, I think, mixed in with civilian populations. We need weapons that are going to allow us to be able to sort, minimize what they call collateral casualties. I think the battlefields are going to be in urban areas.
And if you look at the active denial system or the high-power microwaves or the LRAD, the acoustic weapon, what you see is enthusiasm for those are being displayed by U.S. Northern Command, which is the Homeland Defense Command, or other counterterrorism organizations, which are looking at them like, oh, well, maybe in some special circumstances we can take these secret weapons, boutique weapons, we only have 10 or 20 of them somewhere in a secret place, and if we need them, we can pull them out and use them in this kind of specialty warfare. So ironically, even though Americans would probably think, oh yeah, special new weapons, it would make sense because Iraq is such a mess, maybe we can do something, turn the corner in some way with the use of these weapons. The truth is that the only real way in which they, the military, sees the prospects of the deployment of these is in their domestic use. And you know quite well that if the United States adopts these weapons for their domestic defense, NATO and Italy are not far behind.